Craigslist. Wherever you are, you can buy stuff. Wherever you are. Craigslist.
Craigslist. Here we go. Day three of the coronavirus.
Day two.
What day is it? As you could tell, in studio, I have a special guest, my beautiful girlfriend, Shyer. Say hello.
Hello.
Put the mic closer, can you, a little?
It's as close as it goes.
Oh, okay. And in your lap, we have our very spoiled pup, Teddy, who is loving coronavirus.
Yeah, it's his favorite. It's my favorite, too, actually.
We are on vacation. Chaos. Hold on. First of all, let me give a couple shout-outs to everybody. Thanks for listening. Thanks for telling your friends. I see the numbers going up. I know people are bored. People are probably asking you, hey, what do I listen to? What do you listen to? Send them here. We appreciate it. Shout-out to everybody that bought a book. Shout-out to my man, Eddie Ortiz. Just doing the damn thing. Let me see who else is on here that I need to really give a shout-out to. Eddie Ortiz, just always supporting. I got some stickers and tickets and whatever I need when I see you in person. We've sold a bunch of books, which will help us get through this chaos. Thank you to the Patreons. We're trying to have a big month. I am literally shooting my shot on, I'm just sending messages to everybody saying, hey, you're bored, I'm bored, let's do podcasts. So I got a couple big comics lined up. A couple big comics said no, but hey, we tried. And Shyer and I are doing good. She's feeding me very well. Mm-hmm. What do we have today?
What did we have today?
Yeah. Well, what was our lunch?
Our lunch was a Southwest taco salad with shrimp.
Ooh, which was amazing.
It was.
What's for dinner?
For dinner, we're having bacon-wrapped pork chops with asparagus and homemade poor man pierogi. Gluten-free.
So, yeah, it's going pretty good here, actually. I can't complain. Shire's loving it. I'm loving it. We have an amazing landlord who I grew up with who hit us with the no rent this month text.
Yeah.
So everybody's working together. Everybody's buying my books. You guys are Patreoning. You guys are sharing it. My landlord is the best. Thank you, DJ Davenport, for being incredible. Chaos is set in at the house. We are so bored. I just shaved my face, and it looks so bad. And Shyer just keeps looking at me laughing, and it sucks. And no, you guys can't see it. I'm sorry. But I've been wanting to shave my face for a while because the gluten makes my face break out.
You just look like a totally different person.
I look like an awful person with a fat double chin.
No, you don't.
It looks awful. Every time I glance in a mirror, I go, oh, God, who is that?
Well, that's kind of how I feel, too, minus the oh, God part. But you don't look like yourself.
Teddy wouldn't even come talk to me. He's avoiding me. He's scared of me. My face is, super red around my mouth. This is not where you want to have this look right during the coronavirus. My face says coronavirus right now, don't you think?
It's psoriasis.
Yeah, but it's all around my mouth and chin.
Well, coronavirus doesn't cause psoriasis.
Yeah, but I don't know anything about coronavirus. And if I saw a guy walking towards me with a big red mouth, I'd say, get away. Shyer was giggling so hard, shaving my beard, that she just shaved a little of my lip off. So I'm probably also going to have a big scab that looks like a herpes on my lip. And so, yeah, we're doing good at the Corona Village. We are here. So
we did it. We did it today, though, so that it would have time to grow back in before you had to see people.
Yeah, for sure, because nobody will see me. She was trying to get me to cut a mullet while we were at it. We're trying to just ruin everything. No one would just gonna fuck me anyway, but now she's making sure, I don't know if she thinks these girls out here are just lonely, and when I go on my daily walk, they're just going to be throwing that pussy at me, but that is not going to happen.
Shaving your face was your idea.
I know, but it looks so bad. So, anyway, I'm going to try not to dwell on it and record some podcasts and stay down in my basement where no one can possibly see me. I might wear a mask when I go out just to cover my mouth and out. I had a goatee for a minute, and that was that's too creepy.
And then you had a really awesome mustache.
I know. So, It's the sucks. I'm just going to be honest. It sucks. There's
and
nothing.
We went on like an 8-mile walk today, so I think we're both a little sore. And
yeah.
It's turned out to be a weird day.
I've made a commitment to try to put out a podcast a day, try to at least get 15,000 steps, and don't drink alcohol for this quarantine for a month. Mm-hmm. Try to lose some weight. Mm-hmm. I shaved and immediately went and checked. I've already gained 1.5 pounds, which is driving me fucking crazy because I worked out yesterday. I had 20,000 steps. Today I'm over 17,000. I haven't had any booze since Sunday.
I know.
It just sucks. It's a hard life, but there's people that have it worse. So hopefully that's not none of you guys. Hopefully you guys are doing good. Hopefully you're all healthy. Everybody around you is healthy. And you are fighting off this boredom. And financially, you're doing good. This is all we can hope.
Yeah.
And like I said, thank you for the Patreons. It's going to be my only source of income this month besides my books. But if you're strapped for money, get rid of that Patreon. I will not. You're part of this team. The fact you signed up at all. I will always appreciate, and I totally get it. So now, it's time for Shyer's favorite thing. Mm. Why are you so nervous?
I just hate it.
Why do you hate it?
It just makes me have so much anxiety.
About what?
I don't know. About, like, I don't know.
Just talking to people.
I know.
A lot of times I try to give, like, good advice, and, like, yesterday I'm trying to help this guy. We've been emailing back and forth trying to get his 1-2 flush, trying to give him the motivation to go chase his dreams. Does that make you feel better?
I mean...
Okay, well, here we go. Shyer, welcome to Craigslist Chaos. Where do you want to start? Give me a city.
Oh, my brother just moved to Wisconsin.
Wisconsin, here we come.
It starts with a D, the city that he's in. I don't know what it is. Delaney or something?
Land of the cheese. They probably don't have it because they only have... hold on. I went to Washington. You want Wisconsin. It'll be Duluth. Here's your D cities.
Yeah, maybe.
Duluth.
Is that near Milwaukee?
Sure. Duluth Superior is where we're going to start this search.
All right.
Your brother's name is what?
Shane.
Shane. So when if we talk to anybody in Duluth, we will be Shane. Are you okay with that? And you can be Shauna. But I have a feeling you're not going to talk to anybody.
I'm not talking to anybody.
Okay, here we go. If anything comes to mind, you like it. Personal grocery shopper.
Look, I got sunburned today.
You did. But this is a audio medium, so please quit showing your sunburn off. The listeners can't hear that.
All right.
Okay. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Personal grocery shopper.
Sure.
You want to talk to them?
Right now is a bad time.
Do the coronavirus pandemic, I'm available. Do your personal shopping. No. We're looking for like scams or people we can fuck with.
All right.
These people are trying to help. Duluth to Eli. You want to ride with someone? Hoping you're going to Eli and I could catch a ride. Any time is open. No. Side work wanted. Reliable, responsible babysitter. Lost my passport. Reward offered. What would you pay for if you lost your passport? What would your reward be?
Nothing. I would just get a new one.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
That's a big-ass long process.
Okay, so a passport costs, like, what, $150?
Yeah, but you have to wait for it. It's a pain in the ass.
So then $250 for the convenience of me finding it and just giving it back to you.
So if you lost your passport, we'd put up a $250 reward?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's fair. If you found a passport and don't know how to locate the owner, please send me the owner's initials. If they are mine, I'd like to know and I will call you. If it's mine, I will gladly pay a reward to get it back. We don't need to mess with them. That's a weird way of doing it though, right? Yesterday we had this guy with a cat. He wouldn't tell me his cat's name no matter what. But he told me his wife's name.
Why wouldn't he tell you his cat's name?
I don't know, because there's a lot of weirdos on here.
What were you talking to him about?
Well, his cat, he lost his cat. And then someone was feeding it, and then he wanted to, like, he was like, now he wants to co-own the cat with whoever's feeding it. It was a fucking weirdo.
My friend Brandy has a cat that they let indoor and outdoor, mm-hmm. and their neighbor was feeding it and letting it in their house. And my friend Brandy obviously is feeding it and letting it in her house. So Brandy went to the neighbors and asked them to stop feeding her cat.
Mm-hmm.
So the next time they saw the cat, they just took it to the Humane Society and dropped it off.
Jesus.
So the Humane Society, so the cat is chipped, microchipped. So the Humane Society calls my friend Brandy and they're like, hey, we have your cat and you have to pay us like $80 to get the cat out of Humane Society jail. And she's like, it's these fucking neighbors that stole my cat in the first place.
I'll tell you, I know a guy that I hate this guy actually now. Well, I won't put him on blast, but I know a dude, he stole his neighbor's cat.
Why?
Well, he just didn't think they were taking good enough care of it. So he just took it, and then they just made it a house cat, and then just prayed that the family never saw it.
That's terrible.
I know, but in his defense, he thought he was giving it a better life.
You can't take someone's pet.
I know, but he did. And we thought it was funny at the time because he was an older comic that we looked up to, but now not so much.
Well, who is it, Cosby?
No, it's not Cosby. It's this guy named Joe Lowers. He runs the World Series of Comedy, which is a total scam. Mm. He's the one that kicked me out of it, and then I showed up, and he tried to kick me out, but they couldn't. That's a story for another time. Here we go. You want to get a gig in Duluth? Voice actors audition wanted. We're making an animated sitcom. We're in the area of Bob's Burgers. With the irrelevant ballpark of South Park. Call or text me to see if there's a fit. No joke. If we get picked up and your voice is used, we all have work. And fun work at that. That sounds like this is a good job.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to audition with me?
Maybe. Okay. I've got voices.
Okay. Well, we're going to call him and say, hey, my girlfriend and I. Don't say anything about my face.
Listen, you need to just like pick up on my like staring at you. Not if you want speaking, in. Meaning that I'm not going to participate.
Okay.
I probably won't participate. Well, it just makes me so nervous.
There's nothing to be nervous about. We're trying to get you on a, on this cartoon. Here we go. Billy. Billy, don't you lose my number. I got to clear my voice. I'm ready. I'm ready, Billy. Billy, come on now. Billy. Say hi to Billy.
Hey, Billy.
Hi, this is Billy Hopp. Thanks for calling. Leave a message for me and I'll get back with you as soon as I'm able to.
All right, Billy.
At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Hey, Billy. If you like my voice, call me back. I'd love to be a part of your TV show. Thanks so much. All right. See you later. That's how you get a job in these tough times.
Later, loser.
Need one helper. That's it.
Need one
helper. I need one mover helper between Duluth and Cross Lake 24 days ago. Should I call him? Say, hey, you still need me? Fifth Wheel Movers. What's that shitty movie we watched last night?
Ooh, what was it? Spencer Confidential.
If anyone tells you to watch that, tell them to go fuck themselves, because it is ridiculous that Marky Mark's like 5'7", and they beat up everybody. Where do you want to go? Minneapolis?
Sure.
I think we went to Minneapolis. Let's go somewhere else.
All
right. I need some more music. We need the mischief music.
Oh.
Green Bay. Let's go to Iowa City. What?
Your face.
Quit making fun of my face. How dare you? It just says driver, professional driver, tired of waiting on cabs. No. My caucus escape friend. What does this mean? We're in elementary school between the first and second associations during the caucus night. You said this is my chariot. What's up, babe?
I really feel like I want to have a pet snake.
Oh, okay.
Since you won't let me have a cat.
Okay.
In real life, and I want to keep it. Okay. So maybe we could find one.
Yeah.
Are they expensive, do you think?
Well, you know what? You came to the right place if you're looking for a snake. There are snakes all over. Snakes on a plane, snakes all over.
I want like a cool colored one that is not poisonous. And I don't think that exists in nature.
You know what? We're going to let you talk to somebody and see. Okay, next time we find a snake. Little Tots, English Spot Babies.
What?
I don't know. They're bunnies. I have two English Spot Rabbits that are ready for their new homes. You want those?
Teddy would kill it.
They're both bucks, two marked blacks. They were born on June 3rd.
Aww.
They're very friendly bunnies.
They don't seem like babies anymore.
Should we call them, try to get them?
No.
Okay. Large handmade dog beds. Wanted kitten. This sounds like you. I'm looking for a kitten to add to our family. I'd like an orange or white kitten. Prefer a male, but willing to consider a female.
Orange cats have more health problems.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Should I tell him that?
You can.
Should I just call him and tell him that? CMA tickets 2020 canceled. Unfortunately, I can no longer make it to 2020 CMA Fest, so I'm selling my two tickets. When is it? This is probably canceled, right? Should I call him and see? Hey, CMA tickets canceled? Do you want to go to CMA?
I don't want to know if the CMAs are even going to happen.
Well, we're going to call him and find out. Who's your favorite country artist?
June 4th to June 7th.
I know, that's what I'm saying.
Probably still going to happen.
You think so? We're about to find out. CMA Fest.
Hello?
Hello. How are you, sweetie?
Who is this?
This is Greg.
Who is this?
This is Greg. Don't yell at me. Hey, do you still have your CMA tickets?
Yeah, I do.
Are they going to cancel it, or do you think it's going to happen?
Oh, I think it's still going to happen, but that's the coronavirus isn't why I'm selling them.
Oh, you don't have it?
No, I do have... The tickets come in the mail in May.
Oh, so you don't even have the tickets yet?
No, they don't. They're not. They don't get mailed to me until May.
How come you're not going?
Because my friend bailed on me.
Oh, why'd they do that? Do they have the coronavirus?
No.
Why did they? Who misses the CMA with their best friend?
I don't know. How did you get my number?
Your friend told me to call you because you were selling them because she didn't want to go with you.
Bullshit.
Huh?
Bullshit.
Whoa.
Did you get my number off Craigslist?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I saw it on Craigslist. You're right. Sorry. I get confused sometimes. Someone was telling me that you had some, though. I think Bobby. So do you want to sell them, or do you want to come with me, or what do you want to do here?
I'm going to sell them.
You don't want to come with me? I'll put you up on my shoulders, and you can cheer for... Who's your favorite? Luke? Dirks? Garth?
No, it's all... I'm going to sell them.
But you don't want to go?
Like, no, I'm just going to sell them.
Oh, okay, good, because I want to sell them. So how much do you want to sell them for? I'd like to take my girlfriend. She's never been. Do you think she'll like it?
$580 a piece.
So that's what, $960? Let me see. $960 for two tickets. What if it gets canceled? Can I have my money back?
No.
No?
$580 a ticket.
$580 a ticket. So $1,040. Okay.
$1,160.
Oh, $1,160?
Yeah, and if it gets canceled, like ordered this through Ticketmaster, then Ticketmaster would reimburse.
Would reimburse you? This is a good way for you to make a lot of money. Then
no, they would reimburse you because I would be switching the tickets over to you.
Oh.
I would transfer them in the Ticketmaster wallet.
Okay. What's your gut feeling? Do you think it's going to happen or no?
No.
Oh, you don't? So I probably shouldn't buy them then. Well,
I don't know. I truly don't think it's going to get canceled.
All right. Well, you truly think it is or it isn't?
It isn't.
Oh, it isn't? So I should buy them.
Like, I think it would have already been canceled by now.
All right. All right. Well, let me talk to my girlfriend. Sorry about your friend leaving you. Are you still friends with her? Hello? All right. Guess we're done. Why'd you give up? You couldn't listen anymore?
Stresses me out. You just push him and push him.
I was trying to talk to her, be a friend.
I know.
Okay. Well, we're not going to CMA, babe. I think you heard the bad news. But don't you like when I try to do bad math?
I want to know how old that girl was.
Well, you jump in and ask her.
Well, am I allowed to?
Yeah, there's no rules. It's chaos. The crazier ever. Gosh. Here we go. Iowa artist seeking stories. I'm working on a music project about storytelling and hoping to have stories donated, preferably in audio format. You want to tell someone a story?
Sure.
In a Russian accent?
Yes.
Okay.
No, I don't. I can't. I don't think I can hold it together. I can try.
Hold on. I think they just wanted a voicemail. Need a loving home. Needs a home soon. What do you think? Is this a snake or no? Good farm home. High quality preschool. You want an aquarium for $75?
Nope.
Do you want a pet portrait?
A pet portrait.
Yeah, it says pet portraits.
I bet they're awful.
You think?
Yeah.
I don't know.
They're advertising on Craigslist. They can't be that good.
Lost a silver necklace with a charm. My cat is missing help. What? Pet portraits. Custom hand-drawn art. Oh, he'll draw Teddy. Mm. $80. No? Pass?
Pass.
Missing cat? My cat is missing. Please help. That made you laugh?
Yeah.
His name's Atlas. He's been gone for 3.5 months.
He's not coming back.
Yeah. Do you want to call and tell her that? No. Lost Red Wing boot.
What?
Red Wing size 10 fell out of UPS package car while delivering out there Tuesday. Call me. 26 days ago. Do you want to call him?
What a weird thing to post about.
Yeah, that's what makes this great. You never know. I think I found it. Found a boot. Hey, guy, you find your boot yet? We'll see. Do you want to do this one or me?
You can do it.
Come on. Hello, bubs. I try to just talk to him right off. Be friends. I lost a red boot. Oh, here, I got a good one, though, coming up. I guess he found it. I'll put a boot in your ass. It's the American way. All right, babe. This one says, really, Carlisle? Next door app? What the fuck is next?
What?
Are they all morons? Obviously, it's the cops. What's just as obvious is that they didn't do their homework. Oh, I don't know this person. Sometimes they write these crazy rants about shit, but they never leave a number so I can call them. All right. We got to get you a snake.
Why would you just randomly write that?
Babe, you never listen to the show, but this is how it always is. All right, here you go. Handyman service. You want a handyman? Looking for anyone who has something they need done but can't do themselves. Australian German Shepherd puppies must go.
Aww.
These are adorable. Rehoming fee, only $100? That's crazy.
I bet they all have diseases.
Think so?
Probably.
A Chihuahua, Multi-Misc, Red Nose Pit Pups. Someone just wrote, I miss you. I doubt you'll ever see this. But I feel like it must be said even on Craigslist.
This isn't missed connections. What do they think?
That was one, but they never put. Free hutch. You want a hutch?
No.
I have a hutch that is free for whoever wants it. Most of it is in great condition, but some pieces are unusable. It's currently disassembled. You must take every piece, usable or not. No holds. First one to show up gets it. There seems to be some confusion about this post. You are to pick this up from me. I do not and will not deliver it to you. Seeing as to how it is free, that is not out of reason. If this ad is up, this person's going to be cranky. Lotted. I'm going to see if they can get them to deliver it to me. We're going to do everything they said they don't want to do.
Oh, my God, babe.
Hutch. What's up, Hutch? Hutch.
It's been forwarded to an automatic voice message system.
I think nobody wants to talk to you because they know that I'm on the call.
No, people never want to talk to me anyway. The listeners are laughing at you because we get more voicemails than anything. Like when I let stupid Josh Nelson come in, he's like, you got to edit it. I was like, you know how much fucking editing this would be? Okay, people, I need a little help here. This could be us. I'm in Clinton mode, break time, gas station, stop to get gas, but cucking lost me the damn credit card, so now I'm in a bind. 18 days ago. Let's call him. See.
He's in a bind what? He wants money?
I don't know. I can't read any of this. Can't show you that you works with my cord. You put 10 or 15 in my tank.
Oh, geez. He wants money.
Yeah, but I'll send him $10 if he's a good caller.
Just put your Venmo handle on it. Don't put your phone number on it.
I doubt this guy knows what Venmo is, if you could see the way his grammar is. This was 18 days ago. See if he's still stuck.
All right, you call
him. Nope. He can't even afford his phone bill. He's no. So broke.
Looking for male to Sir Female Rottweiler. Is your kid's school closed? Call me. Sweet Belgian Shepherd mix. Looking to meet new people. 18 to 26. This could be you, Shy. They'll get excited to hear your sexy
what,
voice.
I'm not 18 to 26.
Yeah, but you sound like you're 23. Mm-hmm. They don't know it's Craigslist, babe. They're not going to throw the challenge flag. Rico the chauffeur. Belgian Shepherd. Black Lab mix. Daycare. Darling Herding Dog. UKC Bully. CDL, a guide to go for a cruise. There's a lot of gay dudes on here trying to get, looking for a masseuse. Still trying to get your MIDI or USB instruments to talk with each other. What is this? What is going on here? You want to go talk to the Mormons?
Sure.
I try to buy you engagement rings from them a lot.
I saw this meme the other day that said, is anybody going to tell the... Oh, shoot. What are they called? What are the ones that live in, like, Pennsylvania and they don't drive cars?
Oh, the Amish?
Yeah. Is anybody going to tell the Amish about coronavirus?
How about this guy? It just says, Sherry, call me about swimsuit. About Sports Illustrated Swimsuit Edition.
Shut up.
Lost connection due to interruption. Call me, Jim. No number, though. That's what we're looking for. Text me for free estimate.
God, Jim, what a creep show.
We don't do texts. We can help with your old appliances. Dog life jacket, small, $10. Found a pit bull. Rush hour gas station. What do you think this is? Short hair brunette with a tiny perfect body. I can't tell if you're hitting on me or if you're just a sweetheart, but God, I'd love to have some alone time with you.
Oh, my God.
Do you call everyone that name or is it just me? What's the nickname and what vehicle do I drive? This would be you if there's a phone number, but no. Jimmy Hudson, it just says, do you know who Jimmy Hudson is? Anyone know if Jimmy is still in KC or did he move back to St. Louis? Haven't been able to get a hold of him in a while. Call me, Jimmy. It's been too long. Come on, man. Be a number. I'll be Jimmy. Damn.
Why does nobody post their number? Because they know you're going to call them.
Yeah, but there's a lot of scams on here, I think. Looking to start a band. Need a place for band practice. I can't believe I haven't found you a snake yet. Cheapest fun babysitter Monday through Friday.
It's because you need to look in, like, Florida.
Rides offered. All right, we'll go to Florida if that's where you want. I said yes. That's all it says. What do you think this means? Pretty girl at license office who told me I would make a perfect daddy. I didn't mean to blow you off. Had to take an important call. Creepy.
Yeah.
I said, yes, I would be willing to spoil you. Hit me back, nerds. Large tortoise food, 20 pounds.
What?
Oh, I tried to buy this already and see if they'd let me feed it to my dog. They didn't care. All right, we'll take you down to Florida. Take you back to your home state. Probably shit people you went to high school with. Where in Florida do you want to get your snake from?
I don't know. Probably South Florida is better than...
Okay, give me a city. Oh, just South Florida. Mm-hmm. Here he goes. South Florida, here we come, the return of Shire, back to our home. Looking for a person to help me from their home. Hello, my name is Rick. I'm looking for a person that can help me with a few things. That person that I'm looking for can do everything from their home or apartment. I need a person to help me for a few hours a week. Please call or text me so we can talk by phone. I will give you details.
Is there a phone number on
yes.
that? Yes. What is the phone number?
You want to call it?
Well, I don't know. My stepdad's name is Rick.
786?
No, it's, we're
okay.
good.
All right, I might bring you in. He might just want a girl. I don't know what he wants. This sounds like a weird call, right? The Ricker. Looking for a person to help me from their home. Don't call me on some bullshit. Someone text me.
What?
Someone just text me. Don't call me on some bullshit. I don't know.
Was it the voice guy?
I don't know, because we didn't really leave a message for anybody. Oh, it might have been the CMA girl. Hello. Damn it. Come on, Rick.
It's dinner time for these people, babe.
Babe, it's 10:15 in Florida.
Please leave your message.
It's sleep time. Don't call me on some bullshit. Who is that? That had to be the CMA girl, right? I'm going to call her right back.
Do not.
What are you talking about?
All right.
What? No, you can't leave. We don't even know what this is.
Five, six, three, three.
Was that girl, you think?
I don't know.
All right, we got to get you a steak. Happy holiday to you from me.
You could probably type
mature lady snake. For a mature man. Call me. Let's chat and connect today, tonight or the weekend. Sharon. Oh, we've called Sharon before. See, the thing is, some of these people never go away. Sell me all types of video gaming stuff. We want to buy anything. We have cash. Let me make you something beautiful. Oh, this guy's a painter. Turn your photo into a portrait. All right. Help me find my Pomeranian. Jubilee macaw baby. What's that mean, babe? Do you know?
No,
oh, a bird?
No idea.
Now accepting deposits on this gorgeous and super tame macaw. You can ship it? So you can buy birds on here. I can't believe we haven't found a snake. Wanted one female Quaker parrot. Time to paint your clothes empty businesses or empty home. A lot of dogs. Missing dog collar. Someone in New York City, like Upper East Side, was selling like a cat toy for $4 yesterday. I was like, if you live Upper East Side, you're not.
If you live Upper East Side, then that means you live in New York, which means you have coronavirus.
Well, I didn't think
and your
that.
Cat toy probably does too.
Need help finding iPhones. I'm an eBay reseller, is currently searching for iPhones. If you happen to have any old iPhones or know somebody who does, give me a call. No. Prince Charming. Oh, it's a dog. One left. Damn, I can't believe. Searching for someone who can help with a few things. Oh, this is a Rick again.
All I want is a snake.
I know. Golden Retriever.
Oh, that would be nice, too.
I will help you pick up Golden Doodle Kitten. Reasonable fee, it just says. Reasonable fee for what? During this hard time for anyone needing a babysitter, I'm available. Stephanie. What's reasonable, you think? Puppy, parrot. Male green eyes available to be rehomed. This could be a snake. No, it's an incredibly cute dog. I can't believe Florida doesn't have any snakes for you.
I know.
You know what?
Why don't you just search snakes for sale?
Call me. Snakes. Okay. Snake. Here you go.
Yes.
If interested, call me. There is a rehoming fee. Look at this snake. It is beautiful.
Really?
Yeah. Look at this. It's white and black. And you want to try to get it?
Oh, that is a weird looking snake.
Well, here you go. It's yours.
How much is the rehoming fee?
I don't know. That's what you have to talk to him. Put your charm on him. Try to trade it.
Oh, I got to tell you something.
What?
Janae just posted a quarantine clean face challenge.
No, I saw it. I'm not doing it. Stop. Pay attention. Get ready to get the snake. Here you go. This is all you. It's Joshua. This is who you're looking for. You got this. Get ready.
Hello.
Hello. Who is this?
Who's this?
Well, I just heard that you had a snake for sale.
Okay.
Hello?
Yes, how can I help you?
Yeah, do you have a snake for sale?
Yes, I do.
Is it poisonous?
No, why would it be poisonous?
Because a lot of them are?
No, it's not poisonous.
Okay.
Ball python. It's a ball python.
How big is it?
It's about 3 feet.
3 feet?
Mm-hmm.
Is that big or little? It sounds big.
Is this a robot?
No.
Why do you sound like this for?
I don't know. Do I sound like a robot? I think I want a snake, and I don't know anything about them, and I don't know what I want, but I saw that you had one, and so I just wanted to call you and talk to you about it.
Okay, why don't you do some research, Google. Research before you buy something, you know?
Well, I mean, how much is it, though?
Would your parents let you have a snake anyway?
Would my parents let me have a snake?
Yeah.
Oh, my parents are dead. All right.
You know what? Where is it? That was very good. Shire's on fire. He thought you were a robot.
I know. I don't sound like a robot.
No, you got to take. You did good, but you have to take control of the conversation.
Well, I don't know. I've never.
But
done
just
this
ask
before.
Anything. Go, hey, will bites ever bit your kids? How much? What's his name? He did kind of punk you and go, hey, bitch, just Google the shit. I guess it is 10:30 in wherever Louisiana is. You know, we'll take it back to California. Where do you want to go? Let's go to the coast or Hawaii. Guam? Can you call Guam?
I don't know.
All right, let's try
it. What language do they speak in Guam? Oh, why don't you just Google it?
Call me in Guam. Let's see.
I bet they have snakes in Guam.
Yeah, you know what? We'll go somewhere. You want California, Arizona, Oregon, Washington, Montana, Idaho? Give me something west.
Give me something west.
Tell me Kanye West. What do you want?
I don't care, babe.
What? We'll take you to Idaho.
Okay.
Boise. Call me if you got a snake. You did pretty good, though. Garter snakes. Here we go. I have a 3-month-old garter snake. Just don't have the time with him anymore. If you have any further questions, email or call me. 9 days ago. Brandon. All right, here you get Brandon. Talk to any snake stuff you want to ask him. Quit looking at my face.
The official language of Guam is English and Chamorro.
Do you speak Chamorro?
No.
Well, you better learn it tomorrow. Here we go. Get a snake. It's Brandon. You can tag me in if you ever.
Hello?
Hi. Is this Brandon?
Yes, it is.
Hi, Brandon. I saw that you have a snake for sale, and I'm interested.
Okay, I have sold both of them.
Oh, damn it. Do you think you're going to get any?
Yeah, more? Not at the moment, I don't.
All righty. Well, you sound really happy about not having your snakes anymore.
Yeah, well, I appreciate you calling, though.
All righty. Have a good night. Hope you don't get corona.
You too.
Bye-bye.
You too.
That was good, babe. All right. I think your voice is freaking them out. Dudes are like, fuck, I'm in trouble. This lady sounds sexy. We need one of these creeps just trying to get a girl to call. They'll fucking jizz in the pants if they hear your voice. Spots for spring break, school, babysitter, puppies. Are you out of snakes? Do you want something else? Seeking side work, lost man's ring.
Yeah, I guess it's probably not good for me to be calling dudes like, hi, do you have a snake for sale? What's your snake wearing?
You should have cranked it up a little. Found dog up at Black's Creek. Agility training equipment. Auto repair. Cheap junk movers. Snake we already called. 6 adorable working border collie pups.
Oh, my god!
Pigeons for sale? You want some pigeons?
No.
We have some pigeons for sale. They are $5.
Jeff might want them.
Who?
Jeff Dye.
Yeah, that's true. Our friend Jeff Dye tries to catch pigeons on the street. It's one of the grossest fucking things in the world. All right, we're going to... Boise seems pretty dead. Elko. You know where Elko is?
Nope.
In Nevada. Hmm. It's a real shithole. Shih Tzu... Super sweet Maine Coon kitten.
Oh my gosh.
You want that?
Yes.
Oh, it's cute too. Maine kitten.
We could go on a road trip for a kitten.
Could go get a cat right now. Dachshund female puppy.
No.
Adorable miniature dachshund.
Stop.
Puppies. One male and one female left. Smart, energetic, and charming.
Yeah. Are they the normal kind or are they long haired?
It didn't say.
There's no pictures?
No pictures.
They're not real.
Pug puppy, Shih Tzu, quick BJ this evening. Looking for a male to have fun with.
Whoa.
I wonder if you call one of these if they'll talk to you or not. Because that whenever I call and they're looking for girls, they get mad. DNA verified sweet parrot. She just turned 9 months old. Very chatty. No aggression, no problems. Eating, no plucking. comes from non-smoking home with two other birds and children. Do you want this one?
No.
No bird?
Mm-mm.
All right. Rescue lab needs rescued again.
Oh, that is sad.
Twin to Boise today. Have gas money. Boyfriend, the pup and I. Oh, I tried to give these people a ride before. You know, we need to get to California. Some of these small states, they don't update. There's not enough action, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Let's try Sacramento. They probably have some snakes. You want to try one more snake call? Sure. You're doing pretty good. But you should be even... Can you do a voice for us this time?
You want snake?
Yes, that's...
I have snake for you.
150.
How much you give me for snake?
Oh, yeah. Wait, is someone trying to get a snake? Damn it. Hold on. There's nobody... And wanted a snake.
I have here. Yellow snake. I don't know what kind. It bite. I bite, I give away.
That's perfect. Let's try Bakersfield. They should have some snakes. No snakes anywhere? Santa Barbara, is that a snake town? Too much toilet paper. Snake out main line. Snake out main line. Special bunny. Adult female eastern spiny soft shell turtle. Big reptile incubator. What, does it have to be a snake, or can you... Oh, here we go. 2019 ball python hatchlings. Hey, female reptile... Hello, fellow reptile keepers. Here's a list of 2019 hatchings I have for sale. For pricing, please call or text me. I'm flexible. Okay, be rushing.
You know what? I gotta tell you, doing these calls is actually changing my mind about wanting a snake.
Why? You don't want one, or you do?
No, just the way that was worded. What? Hatchings?
Hatchlings. Ugh.
No, thanks.
All right, you're talking to Robert, and you're Russian, and you want a snake.
Oh, I don't know if I can be Russian for you, Robert.
Can't. You can't. You're a little Russian princess. You got this.
Hello, you've reached Robert Perez. I'm unable to get to my phone at this time. If you please leave me a brief message with your name and number, I'll be sure.
All right, no snakes for you. No snake for you, young lady. What else do you want? Local news? San Francisco, that's probably not fun. They're all shut down, right? Stockton. Let's just see what's up in Stockton. We'll pay $350 to be a passenger on a Harley or street. I'm a passenger wanting a motorcycle ride, and if you're interested in giving a three-hour ride and get paid for your time, please email me with your response. What? Someone just wants to ride a Harley for 3.5 hours, and they'll pay you.
That's dumb.
Electrician for hire, male for women, looking for a silly, witty, geek introvert to be weirdos with. Hola, senoritas. Left-handed. This guy's crazy. Hopefully there's a phone number. Call him. Come on, dude. He'll take you somewhere special. Damn, no phone.
Jeez. Did I ever tell you about the time that I joined sugardaddy.com? Because I thought it would be a good idea. And the second person to talk to me was like, do you want to go to Mexico? And I was like, no, I don't want to go to Mexico. I don't even know you. And Emily was like, you're doing it wrong.
Yeah. No. Well, then you told me some guy on there was like.
Then some guy was like, if you come to Denver, I'll pay for your gas to get up here. And my response was, screw you. I have a job and I can pay for my own gas. And I don't need you to pay for my gas to come to Denver. And Emily was like, you're doing it wrong. Yeah. You should have said, oh, I would love for you to pay for my gas, except I don't have a car. So first you would need to buy me a car. And I was like, God damn it. I'm bad at this. Yeah.
Well, that guy's bad too. To be a sugar daddy, you're not trying to pay like $20 in gas.
I know. But, I was so offended.
But you can't be offended when they offer you shit.
I know. And then finally somebody was like, do you know what site you're on? And I was like, I don't really.
Lost wedding rings, plural, at the Arco in 15. Ben Holt, Stockton, on Valentine's Day. Security video shows a man in a truck pick them up. You bought $40 in gas and a Red Bull. Please return. The ring was my engagement ring, and we've been married 25 years.
Aww.
No questions asked.
Don't call them. That's sad.
I
won't.
I never try to. We have one rule. We try not to hurt people's feelings. People can't afford lawyers. We're looking to buy Galaxy phones. Popular rescue community with local volunteers. 7 months pregnant looking for a car.
Yikes.
Missing. It's got to be an animal, right?
Hopefully.
$1 per mile. Missing. It is two doggies.
Aww.
I know. Let's see if there's any gigs Craigslist there for you.
Craigslist is depressing.
Yeah. Need sink fixed. Load a truck, $10 per hour. Find a classic car for me. Hey, I'm looking to buy a classic car. I'm willing to pay up to $400 finder's fee, depending on how good the deal is, to someone who can find one for me to purchase. Any condition. How? Drive your local neighborhood. Look for classic cars. Ask your family members. Do not send me posts or classic cars for sale. Call or text me anytime. You want to call this dude?
Who does this guy think he is?
Who do you think you are? I am.
Who do you think you are? I am.
Who do you think you are? I am.
What's that one show that we watch? American Pickers?
Wait, should we call this guy? Say, hey, man.
Hey, who do you think you are? The American Pickers guy?
What kind of car do you want? Just any old car? I mean, there's cars all over. I'm going to call this guy.
Try to sell him Ron's bus.
Oh, should I try to sell him? What kind of car do you want?
You should try to sell him Ron's bus.
Hello?
Hey, is this Marky Mark?
That's me.
Hey, buddy. What kind of... I saw you're looking for classic cars. What kind of car are you looking for?
Pretty much anything two-door V8.
Two-door V8. Okay. That's a lot of options. I'm just saying, I was going to go drive around and look, but I didn't know what you were looking for. So you've made it very easy.
Yeah, pretty much like 60s or 70s Mustangs, Chevelles, Novas, Challengers, Chargers, pretty much anything.
Okay, cool. I'll let me look and I'll get back to you.
All right, sounds good. Right, I appreciate it.
Yep. Just sometimes you just miss. I don't know what
to
say.
Yeah, but I wonder what he does with them. And I wonder if he knows about your weird bus that you want.
Well, what I think is he'll probably try to lowball the people. But that one was for the listeners. So if you guys have one of those cars or if you know one in your neighborhood, you can make $400. You just get the year, make, and model. And then you call them 510-514-7227. So,
Marky Mark.
Marky Mark. So.
Not to be confused with Spencer Confidential.
So if you have one in your neighborhood or if you see one, and now I guess we'll look for one when we go on our walks every day. Hopefully this helps somebody get $400. And if you don't like it, you tell them this.
Shut your mouth, you thong wearing fatty.
You know who that was?
No.
Babe, you have no idea.
Nope.
I'm going to play it again. Try to pay attention.
Shut your mouth, you thong wearing fatty.
It's only the biggest action star in the world. Does that help?
Only the biggest acting star
action
in the world.
Action acting star in the world.
Vince Vaughn.
Oh, my God. You're fired. No. That's The Rock, babe.
Oh.
You know who The Rock is?
Oh, yeah. I know who The Rock is. We go way back.
You're a moron. How's my face looking? Still awful?
You know, I'm getting used to it slowly but surely here.
Because you're stuck with it. All right, we're going to Mormonville. This is where they call the sheriff on me a lot, so be ready.
I am not ready.
If you want to get anxious. Wait, let's try to get you a snake here. What would that be, livestock, you think? You can trade for pets and livestock. Do you want to do that? Collie, here's an aquarium. I like to try to trade people for stuff if you want to trade. Let me see if there's a snake you can trade for. There's a turkey for trade, a vintage clarinet. Any of this sound good to you? Puppies. They'll trade... you can trade for land. Horse training. Girl Friday. I can pet sit, clean your house, walk your dog, clean up after your pets, organize, drive you around. For $1. Kelly. And I'll negotiate with you. Let me know what you need and I'll negotiate with you. What do we want Kelly to do? Anything? That's just dying for dudes to try to get blowjobs. Livestock. Animals.
I don't think my coworkers know how the internet works.
Why? And remember, you're live on air, so be careful what you're saying.
Well, because we all have to file for unemployment until we go back to work.
Mm-hmm.
And nobody can get it to go through today because it's busy. And so I said I might try it like 2 a.m. And one of my coworkers said, but they're not open at 2 a.m. And I was like, it's the internet. They don't have to be open. She said, can you send me the website you're using?
I mean, no offense, but hairstylists have not always been known as the smartest tools in the the sharpest scissors in the drawer.
That's true. That's why every opportunity I get, I tell my clients that I have my degree.
What is your degree in?
Interior design. But then I worked in fashion for 3 years in New York City.
Fashion. Wow, look at this. This is a gutted soda pop machine turned into a gun safe. It's carpeted inside, has shelves and holders for rifles. It can hold a whole bunch of guns. I can't get pictures. It's in my sister-in-law's garage. That's a pretty cool. I'm scared of guns. I don't have any guns, but that's kind of cool, right? Could we put anything else in it?
In a gun case?
Yeah, like umbrellas or so. What would you put? All your. That'd be a cool ass thing to have, like, if at your work, if it was just like, but then you open up a soda machine and it's full of all your
guns.
No, all your shears and cutting shit.
If you just put a bunch of different stuff in machines that they're actually made for.
Yeah.
If you like had a jukebox, but instead of music, you filled it with guns.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe not that cool to you. Here we go. You want to buy a wedding ring?
Do you want to buy a wedding ring?
I'm trying. You want a wedding dress?
Oh, what's it look like? I feel like that's bad luck.
Yeah, but I usually try to get him to tell me the story.
Mm.
So here, you'll call one and then just try to talk to him.
Okay.
$900 for this.
I don't know. Are these the Mormons? I'm scared.
Yeah.
But it just definitely has sleeves.
It does have sleeves.
I know, because they have to have sleeves.
Oh, yeah. Try to get her, ask if she fucked in it.
No, I am not asking that.
Why? A girl could ask that. Okay, here's one for a beautiful, never used size 4 David's bridal wedding dress for $60. Huh. I ended up wearing a different dress. New with tags, has never been worn. Wedding dress for rent. This dress is amazing. I loved wearing it and got so many compliments. The dress is fully laced, size 6. You can rent it for $100. Man, they're Mormon. The dress rent is for $100. If you don't want to dry clean the dress, I will dry clean it for $100. You will love this dress. No?
So $200 for a clean dress or $100 for a dirty dress?
I don't know. Wedding dress, spaghetti straps, size 12.
They're not Mormon.
Timeless wedding gown, new. I'm selling this beautiful wedding dress. I love it so much. I just found one that I like better. I want someone that got dumped. Worn twice. Here's a wedding. Every wedding dress, adjustable size 10 to size 14. Worn twice.
For rent?
$350. Serious inquiries only. That means that's you, babe.
I am not doing that.
What?
What?
When they say serious inquiries only, that means we have to call them. Modest wedding dress, size 4 to 6. 3-foot train. It was beautiful wheat bead. Golden Gate wedding dress. No?
Huh?
If you're not going to call them, then let me get the hell out of wedding dresses. You know? Let me try to... What do you want to buy? This is Utah. You can have anything you want.
That's not true.
Yeah, name it.
Alcohol.
Boom roasted. But maybe. We can't probably sell alcohol online. Maybe. Could you?
Who knows?
Let me go back and see. Oh, I lost it. Don't call me on some bullshit. Call me back. Oh, you want to try to call Brother Bill, as always? Maybe he'll answer.
If he answers, I'm talking okay, to him. Wait, what's your name again?
Brother Ken. We need to call him from your phone.
No.
Yes. Just check on him. Damn you, Brother Bill.
Do you want me to leave a message?
He has no voicemail. Oh, most people in the world have no voicemail.
I'm sorry, but the person you called has a voicemail box that has not been set up yet.
It's the devil's work.
I know. You know what? Let me see who I have in our if I have any numbers saved. Betty Joe. Oh, here, call these people.
For what?
I don't know. Just start talking to them. I think they do Uber.
Subscriber's request. This phone does not accept incoming call.
Okay, they're gone. So I've saved a few people's numbers in here. Crazy Brother Bill. Guy that killed his mom, Andrea. I don't know what that means. That's all I have in here. So just start talking to this guy. I have no idea what this is. No, I can't remember what that call is. You want some relationship advice?
Mm.
Oh, this guy will put a curse on people. You want to put a curse on somebody?
No, that's bad karma.
Oh, this guy is super happy. Just start talking to this guy. This is Steven in Yakima. It just says Steven in Yakima, happy guy. Just check in with him. Dang it. All my regulars are gone. Social media guru fuckhead, it says. You ready? Talk to this guy.
Wait, is this just in your phone?
Yeah, that's what I have them saved. Just say I saw your Craigslist ad. Maybe everyone blocked us.
Probably.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
Hi. Is this a robot?
No.
No. Okay. I saw your Craigslist ad, and I just was calling to talk to you about it.
But which ad are you referring to?
Something about social media. I can't remember. I just like jot down your number, and I kept searching.
Yeah, we've already filled that position.
What was that?
We've already filled that position.
Oh, you were hiring.
We filled it.
Gotcha. Yeah. Well, what else do you have?
Hiring.
What else do you have ads for?
Well, we're an auto dealership, so we have ads for a lot of things.
Oh, got it. What kind of cars? I have got a friend who's trying to buy like old vintage cars.
Yeah. Are you here in Phoenix?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, what kind of? I got mid-60s cars.
Oh, okay.
Not vintage, they're classic.
All right. I don't know exactly what ones he wants.
Yeah. All right.
Well.
Well, good luck on your job search.
Thanks.
Or whatever
so much.
You're looking for.
All right.
Okay.
Bye. Take care.
How dare you?
Well, you know they're not all good ones. Sometimes if they're low energy, you gotta crank it up.
Well, you were sitting over there on your phone, so I didn't think it was super important.
No, I just didn't want to distract you and make you giggle. You want to buy some Miami Heat flag for $4? They're selling Rudy Gobert shirts, but he's the guy that got coronavirus.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Do you think that's why they're selling a shirt?
You want to ask him?
Yeah.
All right. Say, what? Are you selling this because he's sick and he's about to die?
He's like, well, not sick.
I would say whatever you want. So I want to buy it for my boyfriend, but...
I'm afraid it's going to give him coronavirus.
Yeah. And just say whatever you want. I like watching you do it. His name's Aaron. Double A.
Hello?
Hello?
Yep.
Hi, is this Aaron?
It is.
Hi, I saw your Craigslist ad. You've got some, I think it's a basketball player maybe, something for sale?
Mm-hmm.
It's a shirt? Is that right?
A jersey.
Okay. Sorry, I don't really know anything about sports at all. But my boyfriend really likes sports, so I thought maybe it'd be something that he would like.
Okay.
Who is it? Who is on the jersey?
I have a couple of them on there, so I'm not sure which one.
Okay. Which ones do you have?
Joe Ingles. Like Joe Ingles from the Jazz?
Okay, I don't know him. Anything else? Or is that the only one?
No, I have Donovan Mitchell.
Okay, I don't know him.
He's the most popular player on the Jazz.
He's the most popular player on the Jazz? Well, I told you I don't really know sports too much.
Yep. Yeah, him and Rudy Gobert, I have both those.
He's the one with coronavirus, right?
Yep.
You have his jersey?
Mm-hmm.
Have you washed it?
It's not his jersey. It's just a copy of it.
Oh, gotcha. Okay. So if I bought that one, I know that name just because he has that coronavirus. If I bought that one, it would be safe. I wouldn't have to worry about it.
Yeah.
All right. Well, let me just keep looking. I might call you back.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
You're too good. You're just the most chill. It's like, hey, I don't know sports. This is an authentic 1988 women's Russian volleyball team jersey. Volleyball and program. All are framed and signed by the team. I got to buy this. Do you want that? 1998 women's USA volleyball team jersey. Volleyball and program. I got to get that.
Who do you know that coaches volleyball? Trent?
Yeah, but in elementary school, why would we need to buy it for him?
Yeah, you could say my cousin coaches volleyball.
My cousin coaches volleyball. I'm looking to get him a gift. Coaches fifth graders. He's an asshole.
Hello.
Hey, is Jody there?
This is Jody.
Hey, Jody. How are you, buddy?
Great.
I thought you were going to be a girl. Hey, you still have this volleyball jersey signed by everybody?
I do.
It's pretty sweet. How'd you get it?
Oh, what did I got it at an auction, I think, if I can remember right.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, shoot. Let me call you right back.
All right.
Babe, go.
Hello? Hello?
Dang it. We lost the happy Steve. In my notes, it just says Steven and Yakima, happy guy. I remember he was super happy. So here he goes. He's calling you. I'm calling. Steven. Just be super happy. He just calls.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. 50.
He just called us. Now we don't even get a...
He just called us.
All right.
Babe, I need to go make dinner.
Okay. Hold on. There's a BYU whack champ ball sign for $10,000. I own this ball since a child. Only 50 of these balls were ever produced for public. I met Mr. Edwards where he told me the story of the ball and kindly signed it. And after he told me he didn't sign any of them balls and I own the only one, the ball is rare and I'm worried my daughters may get a hold of it. And kick it down the road. Taking offers. Texas Best. Also open to trades.
Wait, he's afraid his daughters might get rid of it?
$10,000 ball. This is crazy. This thing can't be worth more than $50. This guy, I'm going to say, how much? Oh, I think Steven might have left us a message. Zach. Ziggity Zach. Zachary.
Hello.
Is Zach there?
Hello.
Is Zach there?
Yeah.
Is that you?
Yeah.
Oh, you're you're really bad at answering the phone. Hey, I'm calling about you still have that basketball signed? BYU?
Oh, it's a football.
Oh, it's a football?
Yeah, it's their BYU WAC championship football.
From what year?
84.
84, wow. Who's the star player?
There was Robbie Bosco. There was a whole bunch of people on that team that year.
And how much are you selling it for?
I'd have to look.
You got to check the price tag?
I met Lavelle and had him sign it, and that was only for – those balls were for direct staffing.
Uh-huh.
And he asked where we got it. And
where'd you get it?
So we had bought it from my mom bought it from a yard sale many years ago.
Oh, wow. Good job, Mom.
Yeah, and I have the only one with his signature on it.
Holy.
He has that ball.
Good job, Mom and Lavelle. So you're trying to sell it before your daughters start playing with it?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's scary. But you don't know how much you're selling it for?
I'd have to see what I had it listed at.
All right.
I have not had it graded.
Uh-huh.
Sent in or authenticated. It's real. I know for a fact it's real, but...
Wait, you know it's real because your mom bought it at a garage sale?
Yeah, that and Lavelle. And I've seen all the autographs.
Well, you know the Lavelle one's real, but the rest you don't really know, right?
Oh, no. Lavelle told me that ball was real.
He checked...
And my dad.
Oh, well, if your dad's...
100%. It's not a normal ball.
Why don't you post special. A picture of it?
There's not a picture of?
No, just there's like a gray bike. That's why I thought it was a basketball signed by Herm Edwards. You got to get a picture up.
Yeah. Let me.
You work on that. I'll call you back, buddy.
All righty.
All right. Love you. Fucking weird Mormons. That ball's not worth, there's not a ball in the world worth $10,000, I don't think. He's like, they're 100% real. I bought them at a garage sale. Like, boy, your mom bought this at a garage sale. All right, last call. What do you want to do? Who do you want to call, babe? Do you want to get this autographed photo album? I think it's got Karolinko in it. You could be Russian. I like the picture of Karolinko. He's my. I went to high school. Can you be Russian lady for this?
Wait, what does it say? Read the ad to us.
It says round 06 of 07 season has pictures and autographs of the entire team. I put some of the better players in the pictures. But it's just like Andrei Karolinko, but he's a Russian.
What is the name of the person
that you're buying it from?
Yeah.
Thomas.
Mm.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
So say I want Karolinko.
It's a photo album? I'm
no,
confused.
These are autograph photos, but say, I just want Russian Karolinko. Or I don't know. Wait, hold on.
Babe, I can't do
it. Here's a voicemail.
Oh, jeez.
I just missed your call. I'm not sure. I don't recognize the number, and my number is 509-388-5126, and it might have all been a mistake. So, God bless you. Have a wonderful night.
Wow, that's a nice guy, but he sounds like he's got the Roni.
Yeah, but he's super fun. Here, talk to him.
We're calling him again.
Steven, yeah.
Whoa, kaboom!
Nothing.
This is going to be...
Hello?
Yeah, hello. Something just blew up in my ear there. Pardon me.
Sorry about that. Is this Steven?
Yeah. Yeah, it is. You have a rock band there or something, a heavy metal band or something. That was bizarre. That was a weird thing. It sounded like music, but it went,
well,
it was like,
yeah,
200
like,
decibels or something.
Oh, gosh. No, no rock band here.
You headbangers. No, that's what I was thinking. It sounded more like that, you know? I mean, some Queensryche stuff or something, you know, I don't know. But, But God bless you anyway. No worries. I've got two ears, so if this one blows out, I'll use the other one. No worries.
What a nice guy.
How are you tonight? And what's up?
Well, you know, not too much. Just staying in, quarantining, hanging out at home.
Yeah. Amen. That's a smart thing to do.
Is that what you're doing too?
Yeah, you got to do it. Yeah, I'm up on the hill here, and and just and helping other folks as much as I can. So you know how that goes.
That's so nice of you. Where do you live?
We're all in this together. I'm in West Valley. If I look out my big picture windows, I'm looking at the Columbia River escarpment and the bluffs on the cliffs and stuff. It's about 27 miles away, but I'm looking over the city of Yakima. So, and then in the backyard, I've got Mount Adams and Mount Rainier and the Cascades and stuff. So,
wow.
You know,
you've got the setup.
No, it's a pretty place. So, yeah, that's for sure. I thank the good Lord for it, because I'm a blessed. I'm a testament to miracles.
You're a buster? Is that what you said?
No, I thank the good Lord for it, because I'm blessed.
Oh, you're blessed.
And I'm a testament to miracles.
Oh,
So
great.
Oh, yeah. So what's up in the world?
Well, I don't
know. Where are you? Your number's from somewhere in Colorado, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm in Colorado. Living the dream out here, looking at the Rocky Mountains. I got the Rocky Mountains one door, and then I got the plains out the other window. And
I've been there. Oh yeah, I know. And I spent a lot of time up in Wyoming, so I've been all over those Rocky Mountains.
I heard there's a buried treasure up. Somebody buried a treasure somewhere in Wyoming or Colorado. Yeah. Did you hear about that?
Oh yeah, I did.
Was it you? Yeah.
No. I've still got my treasure here, thank God. But I've heard about that one, and there's some in Arizona, and I've got property, and I had businesses in Arizona for using stuff down there. So I've been in the superstitions and all that, the Dutchman, the Lost Dutchman, and all that stuff. And
you've been into superstitions?
Oh, the Superstition Mountains, yeah. And
mountains.
And then they just found that cave in the Grand Canyon, and I've been all through the Grand Canyon, the Kaibab and the North Rim and stuff, and that cave they found has treasures from Egypt and all over the world, and antiquities from thousands of years ago all over the planet Maya and stuff and everything, and no one can figure out, you know, because it's like an eighth of a mile from the Colorado River straight up on the cliffs, which is about half a mile from the top. And, you know, up at the rim.
How'd they get up there?
They thought, that's what no one can figure out, how this got. And you're not going to hear about it for a little bit because the government's got the lid on it. But it's like up in Nevada when they found the giants and their tomb that the Indians fought these giants that were, you know.
Wait, there's giants up there too?
Yeah, well, they were 9 to 13 feet tall, and they had red hair, and it says, the history says, they had blue eyes and 6 fingers and stuff.
Is that where Sasquatch is from?
Well, maybe, but actually that's from a different dimension. That's why no one can find anything out about them. There's these little portals around the world, including there's a place called up in Utah. There's a ranch there a family of farmers bought it and stuff, and there's a place that the government now owns, and it's become the second Area 51 because there's a portal there. People, neighbors and farmers back 200 years ago, 150 years ago in America there in Utah had seen things come through this portal, and things that weren't of this earth, and they couldn't explain, but they'd do pictures of and talk about, and then things would go back through that portal. And so there, because of the magnetic grid around this planet, there are places like that, but there's not a lot written about them, because when they're found, they're usually protected and covered up, you know. And when our government gets involved, then you don't hear any more about it. There's a place outside of Sedona, Arizona, and I've got property there, and lived there, and was a teenager tearing up the town, and you know, and stuff, and everything. And the Bradshaw Ranch, some quail on and stuff when I was just, you know, I'm only 19 now, I tell everybody. But now
you're
I got
19?
Well, I got stuck at 19. I just, my birthday was yesterday, and I'm 19.
Oh, happy birthday. It was my mom's birthday yesterday. She's about 8.
Yeah. Oh, ring on, God bless her. Well, see, St. Patrick's Day is the first day to have a birthday, because that's one of those things, because St. Patrick, God bless him, helped, you know, the people and helped, you know, carried them across the river and the flood and the rest of it, helped them in the famine and stuff, and, anyway, so anywhere you go around the world on St. Patty's Day, there's always a party somewhere. So it's a good thing, you know. But yeah, they call it the Skinwalker Ranch. And that's because...
Kaboom!
Are you there?
Sorry, Stephen. I had to cut him off. He'll just go forever. He's a sweetheart, but... He's only 19. All right,
he
last call.
He got stuck at 19. You already said last call. No, I'm going to go make dinner.
He's selling a Kobe Bryant jersey, but he spells it C-O-B-Y, and then he says original Kobe Bryant, but there's no picture.
I think that we should leave on Steven. I'm going to leave on Steven.
You leave on Steven.
All right.
You go make dinner. I gotta call this, because this sounds like a scam right here. I want to buy this Kobe Bryant jersey. That he spelled it wrong. And he has a picture of not a Kobe
it's
Bryant
probably
jersey.
Probably made in China.
No, even this.
If it's Kobe.
Kobe beef. Look at her hitting a joke on the way out. See ya.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system.
Joel Mauer.
Is not available. At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Hey, Joel, this is Kyle. I'm interested in your rare Kobe Bryant jersey. I would love to pay $500 for it if you still have it. I'd even give you $600 if you got it. So give me a call back as soon as you get this. Thank you so much, and have a great day, Joel. Goodbye. We'll see if we can get a call back on this bullshit Kobe Bryant jersey. Karl Malone jersey. A lot of BYU shit. I hate BYU. Growing up in Wyoming, that was our rival. I don't know if I've told this story on here before, but that's the first time I heard people cuss was at sporting events, and they'd chant, "Fuck you, BYU." And I'd just look at my stepdad, Ronnie Huffendick, and say, "Hey, you know, am I allowed to say this?" And I wasn't, but when I got around my friends, it was always fuck you, BYU. Let's see what kind of sports shit they have. Cowboys jersey, Raiders jersey, a vintage belt buckle. We might be out of here. We might be out of here. Where are we at? Yesterday's episode was a long 2-hour one. That's why I panicked yesterday, because I got to get out before. If it goes over 2 hours, I can't put it on YouTube, so I had to wrap it up quick. Vintage Buffalo Bills pennant. I should buy this for my friends that just opened a bar. They just opened up a Buffalo Bills bar, which I think will be a Wyoming bar since all the Wyoming fans love Josh Allen, but they call it Wide Right after Scott Norwood. It's a great little bar ran by comics here in Denver. All right. Joe Ingles, Karl Malone jersey. This guy's still selling all his jerseys. This guy has a lot of jerseys. What are you, a rapper? Man, this is a sick-ass BYU number one hat. Vintage. I mean, I hate BYU. May heaven's blessing find their way to your door, and may sunshine follow you. You seal the days you may have upon the Rockies, the roam those plains. Amen. That's from Steve in Yakima. He's a talker, but he's a good dude. He's a good one. He's a little wild, but he's a good one. You know what I'm saying, guys? Let's see if they have any cool Wyoming gear here that I can buy from these Mormons. No. All right. Well, maybe not. Cowboys. Are you guys all as bored as I am in life? This shit is the worst. You know? It's just so depressing. It's like I just want to have fun again, do shows. But I think the good news is I got us a bunch of guests. We shot our shots. People are saying yes, so I should have a new interview. I'll definitely have a 31 for you guys tomorrow, because I have got people to record. And all right, we're out. I'll do one last call. One last call. We're going to take it to Denver on Craigslist. See if there's anything. Let's see if I can get a gig for something to do. Let's just complain about how bored I am. Call. Gigs. Let's see if there's any event gigs. Let's see. Seeking brand ambassadors, travel work party play, cashiers, concessions, cook. Let's see if they have any creative gigs. Come perform. Want to work in the cannabis industry from home? Seems like a good business. But I never done cannabis. Rent your garage, driveway, or land. Second share of commercial. Tell us your dating stories. All right. Audible Exotic Podcast wants to hear your story. Share with us your most amazing Tinder dates. Look at these guys trying to do a podcast. $10 per recording. Send us as many as you like. Wow, that's a good way to get content. We may invite you to call into the show. Completely optional. Look at them. They're trying to get this little dating website going. Work from home. Mystery shopper. I always wanted to be a mystery shopper. Start your own hemp business. Make $10,000 to $20,000 a month. Talent gigs. Video talent. Open call. Any experience you have as a cam performer, dancer, other entertainer is very helpful, but not necessary. Enthusiastic amateurs are encouraged to respond to this post with two recent photos, and we will reply with details and an opportunity for you to schedule a phone interview. Extras needed for music video. Last call for casting reality show. Horn section. Oh, this band needs somebody horny. And work from home for your safety. Shut up, stupid. Need repairs on dump trailer. Video talent open call. All right, here we go. Open now for school. Call for entries. Gone to the dogs. Full-time slots available now. I'm a stay-at-home grandmother. Open casting call. We're offering rides. I wish they would do it if I could list this by the date. You know, because I feel like, oh, newest. Ah, well, we learned something tonight. I was doing it by relevant. This is just newest. Well, if anything, guys, we won't be seeing as many old calls. Blue nose pit bull, French bulldog, in care office. 11 cases of high brew coffee. I have 11 cases of new and sealed fresh high brew coffee. I sold my business. This is overstock. Well, congrats on that. Second chance bike shop. We need help. Bikes. Yard cleanup. Metro rides offered. Affordable electrician. Lost white cat. Violin lessons. In search of bunny supplies. Experienced sound man. Christian Learning Center. Looking to purchase real estate yard sign. What? Do you have a wooden real estate for sale sign sitting around from previous sale? We'd like to buy it. No. Airport rides. And we are going to be done, I'm afraid. My friends, I'm going to Colorado Springs one last shot. Since this is where Shire's from, and Shire finally joined us. Immediate text replies, 8 a.m. calls only, morning, noon, or night. Do-do-do-do. Lost dog, grocery shopping. You know what? It's just people trying to help, which I appreciate. All right, guys. We tried. We had Shire come in. I hope you... Her voice is... She should be doing a sex line right now. We'd be so rich. But I hope you guys enjoyed it. I have to go up and pretend like I want to do this puzzle with her, which I don't, because it's fucking boring as shit. But, love you guys. Hope everyone's good. And hope, as always, you guys are healthy and having fun. And like I said, I'll have some 31s starting tomorrow. So keep listening and keep washing your hands and your balls and your vagina and your faces and whatever you got. And whatever you do, don't shave your face because you'll look stupid like me. Goodbye.
Craigslist, wherever you are, you can buy stuff. Wherever you are, Craigslist!